Hi my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're looking great and safe at home. In today's video, I will be showing this beautiful gold black makeup look with a beautiful pink lips. You can also pair this up with a beautiful cocktail dress, or you can wear a sari. That's what I'm wearing right here. It's my mom's sari. It's beautiful gold black sari. It really complements my eye makeup really well, as you can see. You can also refer this video for any wedding function or any, like, you can take it as a wedding guest to makeup look. So if you are interested in knowing how I created this look, then please keep on watching. But before going to this video, if you are new here, then please take a moment to subscribe to my channel. Also press the bell icon so that you don't miss any notification every single time I upload a new video. I'm sure you'll have a great time here. So let's be family, and please don't forget to subscribe, it means a lot to me. So now let's get started. So starting off with some skin prep. For that I'm using a toner here, which is from Dumb Dog. This is the anti acne toner. Just hydrate my face, and it really helps to balance out the pH level of your skin and also tighten up the pores. So topping it off with a vitamin C serum, which is from Garnier, and further moisturizing with my favorite Pond's gel moisturizer. You can use any moisturizer that you want, but I'm using a gel moisturizer because my skin is oily, and gel moisturizer suits my skin really well. So you can use any moisturizer. By the way, I will leave all the links of the products like I'm using in this video in the description box. So don't forget to check the description box also. So now I'm just starting off with my eye makeup first. So if there will be any fallout, so we can just fix it out. So I'm just concealing my eyelids with a concealer. Here I'm using a Blue Heaven concealer. You can use any concealer that you want. For eye makeup, I'm using here Makeup Revolution Reloaded palette. I'm taking a black shade on a pencil brush. I'm just placing on the lash line, just very close to the lash line. I'm just simultaneously smudging it out towards my crease. Now I'm making a kind of semi-circle, just halfway to the crease, and connecting it to the lash line just like this, and smudging it with a flat shader brush with a brown shade as my transition shade, just blending out the edges and completing my crease all the way to the inner corner, and taking a smudger brush. This is from the brand Gub, and it's a beautiful smudger brush. So I'm just blending out the harsh edges with this. So further, I'm taking this beautiful foiled golden shade on a flat top brush, and I'm just placing it down on the left overlid. I'll zoom in for you in a bit so that you can see what I am talking about. And yeah, so see how beautiful it looks. The shape looks very 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 beautiful. So now moving towards the face makeup, starting off with a primer. I'm using here the Maybelline Fit Me primer to just prime my face, also to blur out the pores around my nose and the cheeks. For foundation, I am using NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop foundation. Shades will be in the description box. Firstly, I've just dotted off all the foundation evenly on my face and just blended out with my Damn Beauty blender. At this time, it might look that I've applied too much product, but once it's blended, it looks very, very, very natural because it has a beautiful medium coverage. Then I have used Maybelline Fit Me concealer. Shade is in the description box again. Under my eyes, my lips, like around my lips, at the chin and between my brows, and I have just blended out with a same beauty blender off camera. Now I'm just setting all of those concealed areas with a beautiful loose powder. This is a Swiss Beauty loose powder. It's very very finely milled, and it's beautiful powder. I'm just placing the powder on my skin and not dragging. Further, I'll just dust it off like excess powder with a bigger fluffy brush. Now I'm contouring my face with one of my favorite contouring palettes, the Wet n Wild Mega Glow contouring palette. It is in the shade Dolce de Leche, and I'm taking the contouring shade on hollows of my cheeks, like forehead, hairline, and below my chin, and also on the jaw lines. Also gonna contour my nose with a thinner brush. I'm just again placing the color first and just blending out with my beauty blender so that it looks very natural. Edges will not look harsh. Now I'll be using my blush again from Wet n Wild. The shade name is, I think, Mellow Wine. It's not a wine shade, it's a beautiful pink, like dusty pink shade. It looks very pretty on pink outfits or on these smoky eyes. It really complements the eyes very beautifully. So I'm just placing the blush on, like blending it over towards my temples, not on the apples, because that way your cheeks will look chubbier. Now I'm just setting all of those powder products with my LA Girl setting spray. So now, finishing off the eye makeup, I'm just using the same pencil brush and the same black shade. First, just placing it over the lower lash line, just very intensely, and just blending it out with the same flat smudger brush and the same brown shade that we had applied on my crease. So just blend it out very beautifully, because it should look very beautiful, smudged kind of look, and that's what we want. Now I'm taking that brown and black, both the shades, on a fine angle brush to fill in my brows. I'm just filling up the gaps and following my brow shape, that's it, nothing else. So now curling my lashes using my Vega lash curler. Guys, curling your lashes makes a huge difference to how your eyelashes would look after you apply any mascara. So always curl your lashes before you apply mascara to get those false effect kind of lashes. For mascara I have used here is Nykaa lengthening mascara. I have been loving this mascara. I have applied 2 coats on both my upper and bottom lashes. Now applying a kajal. This is again from Nykaa. It's a beautiful kajal. It's a jet black and very pigmented kajal. So I'm just applying this on lower lash line and also gonna tight lining with the same. Now my favorite part, highlighting. So I am applying the Wet n Wild Precious Petal Highlighter. It's a beautiful champagne-y kind of highlighter. So I'm applying here on my highest points of my face, like highest points of the cheekbones, forehead, bridge of the nose, tip of the nose and cupid's bow, and also on the chin. And I will also highlight my inner corner of the eyes and my brow bone with the same highlighter later on, like you would see me doing this later on. So for lipstick, I've used again one of my favorites. It's my go-to lipstick. It's the NYX Lip Lingerie in the shade Exotic. It's a beautiful pink shade, like perfect for every day, and it will suit every skin tone out there. So yeah, it's a beautiful lipstick. It's a liquid lipstick and really long lasting. Also, I am topping it off with the matte lipstick. Like, also it's a matte lipstick, the bullet lipstick, but it's a matte lipstick from Swiss Beauty. It's the shade Bare. It's a beautiful brownie nude shade, so combination of both pink and like brown looks very beautiful with this these kind of eyes, and also on the black outfit. So I have gone to this combination. So yeah, this is my finished look. The sari I'm wearing is my mommy's sari, and these earrings, I've got these earrings for like for 150 or 200 rupees from the local market. It's beautiful earring, and I really hope you guys like this video, like this makeup look as much I did. I really enjoyed making this video for you guys. If you did, then please do show some love to this video, to my channel. Please like and share the video as much as you can, and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, do take care. Bye.